Recent advances in image restoration with applications to real-world problems. This course is brought to you by Gilad James Mystery School. Learn more at giladjames.com. Recent advances. In this lecture, we do not intend to provide a comprehensive survey of existing recent image restoration papers in the literature. Instead, we attempt to provide a glimpse of recent advances from our own perspectives and applications. In particular, we will focus on the following areas. Moreover, we will connect those research areas to some real-world applications. Images can be enhanced from several perspectives: spatial, spatial-spectral, spectral, and spatiotemporal. Here, we focus on methods that use only a single image to improve the spatial resolution. The simplest method is the bicubic interpolation, which does not utilize any external information such as point spread function, PSF. A total of 16 neighbors are used to generate a prediction, and the performance is better than bilinear interpolation, which uses only 4 neighbors. Recently, there are some new developments. A notable one is the algorithm described in, which utilizes the PSF to improve the resolution of a single image. The super resolution algorithm in is based on edge interpolation. There is also a group of methods based on deep learning. Vast amounts of training images are needed to train the algorithm. Another group is using dictionary-based approach. Both the deep learning and dictionary approaches require many training images, which may be difficult to obtain. In Sidia and Lee's lecture in this course, a generative adversarial network, GAN-based approach was introduced to face image enhancement. The key distinction from conventional GAN is that it is an unsupervised approach, meaning that no ground truth images are required for training. Experimental results showed that the proposed unsupervised approach is only 1 to 2 dBs inferior to state-of-the-art supervised algorithms. The lecture also pointed out some failure cases, which the authors knew the reasons and will further improve the results in the future. In Chin et al.'s lecture, the authors present a new framework for fusing results from cross-view images for 3D mesh reconstruction. Real satellite and ground view images were used to demonstrate the proposed framework. It was found that the reconstruction accuracy has been improved by close to 1 meter in one of the areas. In many applications, we may have a high-resolution, HR, image with only a few bands and another image having low resolution but many bands. Pansharpening is an image fusion approach that fuses one high spatial resolution image with another low-resolution, LR, multispectral, MS, image. Earlier pan-sharpening algorithms are limited to images where the panchromatic band overlaps with the MS bands. However, recent advancements have extended the approach to non-overlapping bands. There are 2 recent survey papers in pan-sharpening. In recent studies, pan-sharpened images were observed to improve the performance of some applications. Another lecture in this course by Chu et al. Summarizes a Dirichlet net for pan-sharpening. The algorithm was applied to Masscam image enhancement. In Restaino et al.'s lecture, the authors report an interesting study of using multi-platform data for pan-sharpening. That is, the low-resolution hyperspectral data and the high-resolution pan or multispectral data come from different satellites. In some applications, only MS images are available. It may be useful to synthesize some hyperspectral images using those images so that the performance of some applications can be improved. Recently, there have been some new algorithms such as the Extended Morphological Attribute Profiles, EMAP, algorithm for synthesizing spectral bands. Here, rather than explaining the details of EMAP, we would like to mention a few recent applications of EMAP. The first one is to use EMAP for soil detection. The original MS images have 8 bands. After applying EMAP, 80 synthetic bands were generated. The soil detection performance was improved quite significantly. More details can be found in. Another application is on change detection using heterogeneous images. That is, the images at 2 different times may not come from the same imager. In, we have demonstrated that EMAP has improved the change detection performance in 36 out of 50 cases. In a third application on land cover classification, we have observed that, with the help of EMAP, using only 4 bands, RGB and NIR, can achieve reasonably accurate land cover classification performance that is only a few percentage points lower than that of using 144 bands of data. Here, we consider an interesting application scenario. At time T1, we have one high-resolution, HR, MS Image and a LR MS Image. However, at time T2, we only have a LR MS Image. It will be important to use the aforementioned images and synthesize a HR MS Image at T2. Such scenarios do exist. As shown in, one example is the fusion of Landsat, 30-meter spatial resolution with 16-day revisit period, and MODIS, 500-meter spatial resolution with almost daily revisit. More details can be found in. Another application scenario is the fusion of WorldView with planet images. A third temporal fusion study is for Landsat and WorldView images. Once the fused images are available, more frequent change detection can then be performed for a given area. Fusion of Landsat and MODIS images to create a high spatial and high temporal resolution image sequence. Alban Wan and Shen's lecture on spatiotemporal discusses various spatiotemporal fusion methods for remote sensing images. Pixel, feature, and decision-level fusion approaches were summarized. A few past results from the author's past papers were also included. Image noise can be introduced during the image acquisition process. For example, in low lighting conditions, pixel amplitude-dependent noise, Poisson noise, are introduced. In the past, people have investigated sparsity-based methods and deep learning methods. There are also joint denoising and demosaicing algorithms. Many commercial cameras have incorporated the Bayer pattern, which is also known as color filter array, CFA, 1.0. An example of CFA 1.0 is shown in A. There are many repetitive 2x2 blocks and, in each block, 2 green, 1 red, and 1 blue pixels are present. To save cost, the masking onboard the Mars rover Curiosity also adopted the Bayer pattern. Due to the popularity of CFA 1.0, Kodak researchers invented a red-green-blue-white, RGBW, pattern or CFA 2.0. An example of the RGBW pattern is shown in B. In each 4x4 block, 8 white pixels, 4 green pixels, and 2 red and blue pixels are present. Having more white pixels is believed to help improve the sensitivity of the camera, which is important in low lighting conditions. Numerous other CFA patterns have been invented in the past few decades. 3 CFA patterns. A. CFA 1.0. B. CFA 2.0. It will be good to illustrate the differences between a state-of-the-art method, Demonet, and the NASA's current demosaicing algorithm known as Malvern-Hecutler, MHE. From, it can be seen that the demosaiced images by MHE contain some color distortion artifacts whereas the Demonet images do not have noticeable color distortions. Comparative of demosaicing images. Left column, NASA's existing software, right column, state-of-the-art deep learning approach. There are some new developments in demosaicing CFA 2.0 or RGBW. In, a new pan-sharpening approach was proposed to demosaic RGBW patterns. In, a further improved version by combining deep learning and pan-sharpening was proposed. In, a comparative study of the performance of CFA 1.0 and CFA 2.0 for low-lighting images was carried out. It was found that CFA 2.0 has advantages over CFA 1.0 in low-lighting conditions. It was also observed that denoising can further enhance the demosaicing performance. Finally, a new CFA 3.0 was proposed in which a comparative study among CFAs 1.0, 2.0, and 3.0 was conducted. It was observed that CFA 2.0 has better performance in terms of peak signal-to-noise ratio, PSNR, in low-lighting conditions than CFAs 1.0 and 3.0. CFA 3.0 has better performance than CFA 1.0. Image blurring can be caused by camera motion and built-in factors such as point spread functions in various stages of image formation. In the course, a few PSFs are mentioned, including optical, motion, detector, and electronics. For motion-induced blurring, researchers have developed estimation methods to restore the original images. For NASA's MASCAM application, an interesting approach was proposed to improve the left MASCAM images. The idea was to use the left and right MASCAM images to estimate the deblurring kernel, and then a deconvolution is applied to deblur the left images. Image inpainting is a well-known technique for image restoration. One can remove some image contents and then replace those missing contents with fictitious information. Some conventional techniques include field of experts, FOE, Laplacian method, local matrix completion sparse LMCS, and transformic. More recent methods use GAN for inpainting. We briefly describe these methods below. FOE, the field of experts method, FOE, was developed by Roth et al. This method uses pre-trained models that are used to filter out noise and obstructions in images. Laplacian, this method fills in each missing pixel using the Laplacian interpolation formula by finding the mean of the surrounding known values. Local matrix completion sparse, LMCS, in LMCS, which was developed by us, a search is performed for each missing pixel to find a pixel with the most similar neighbors. After the search, the missing pixel is replaced with the found pixel. This method performs very well with images containing repeating patterns. Transformic, the transformic method was developed by Mansfield et al. It is similar to the LMCS in that it searches the whole image for a patch that is similar to the neighbors of the missing pixel. However, this method transforms and rotates the searched area to find a better match. Generative inpainting, GenIn, a new inpainting method, generative inpainting, GenIn, which is a deep learning-based method, was considered in our research. It was developed at the University of Illinois that aims to outperform typical deep learning methods that use convolutional neural network, CNN, models. GenIn builds on CNN and generative adversarial networks in an effort to encourage cohesion between created and existing pixels. We briefly mention a few recent applications. In, the LMCS technique was applied to automatic target recognition. A recent application of LMCS, transformic, and deep learning can be found in for error concealment in infrared images. In the lecture by Kwan et al., a number of conventional and deep learning methods were applied to digital terrain model, DTM, extraction. It is surprising that JPEG image compression codec is still being used in some applications nowadays. For instance, the Mars rover Curiosity has a number of imagers, which are all using JPEG for image compression. The current practice at NASA is to use low compression ratios, which can only achieve around 3 times of compression efficiency. Since the invention of JPEG in early 1990s, there have been quite a few newer and more powerful compression standards in the literature. In the past few years, there are studies on evaluating a number of compression codecs that can achieve perceptually lossless compression. The findings showed that it is feasible to attain 10-to-1 compression with almost no loss of image quality. Image enhancement. Images can be enhanced from several perspectives: spatial, spatial-spectral, spectral, and spatiotemporal. Here, we focus on methods that use only a single image to improve the spatial resolution. The simplest method is the bicubic interpolation, which does not utilize any external information such as point spread function, PSF. A total of 16 neighbors are used to generate a prediction, and the performance is better than bilinear interpolation, which uses only 4 neighbors. Recently, there are some new developments. A notable one is the algorithm described in, which utilizes the PSF to improve the resolution of a single image. The super resolution algorithm in is based on edge interpolation. There is also a group of methods based on deep learning. Vast amounts of training images are needed to train the algorithm. Another group is using dictionary-based approach. Both the deep learning and dictionary approaches require many training images, which may be difficult to obtain. In Sidia and Lee's lecture in this course, a generative adversarial network, GAN-based approach was introduced to face image enhancement. The key distinction from conventional GAN is that it is an unsupervised approach, meaning that no ground truth images are required for training. Experimental results showed that the proposed unsupervised approach is only 1 to 2 dBs inferior to state-of-the-art supervised algorithms. The lecture also pointed out some failure cases, which the authors knew the reasons and will further improve the results in the future. In Chin et al.'s lecture, the authors present a new framework for fusing results from cross-view images for 3D mesh reconstruction. Real satellite and ground view images were used to demonstrate the proposed framework. It was found that the reconstruction accuracy has been improved by close to 1 meter in one of the areas. In many applications, we may have a high-resolution, HR, image with only a few bands and another image having low resolution but many bands. Pansharpening is an image fusion approach that fuses one high spatial resolution image with another low resolution, LR, multispectral, MS, image. Earlier pansharpening algorithms are limited to images where the panchromatic band overlaps with the MS bands. However, recent advancements have extended the approach to non-overlapping bands. There are two recent survey papers in pansharpening. In recent studies, pansharpened images were observed to improve the performance of some applications. Another lecture in this course by Chu et al. summarizes a Dirichlet net for pansharpening. The algorithm was applied to Masscam image enhancement. In Ristaino et al.'s lecture, the authors report an interesting study of using multi-platform data for pansharpening. That is, the low-resolution hyperspectral data and the high-resolution pan or multispectral data come from different satellites. In some applications, only MS images are available. It may be useful to synthesize some hyperspectral images using those images so that the performance of some applications can be improved. Recently, there have been some new algorithms such as the Extended Morphological Attribute Profiles, EMAP, algorithm for synthesizing spectral bands. Here, rather than explaining the details of EMAP, we would like to mention a few recent applications of EMAP. The first one is to use EMAP for soil detection. The original MS images have 8 bands. After applying EMAP, 80 synthetic bands were generated. The soil detection performance was improved quite significantly. More details can be found in. Another application is on change detection using heterogeneous images. That is, the images at two different times may not come from the same imager. In, we have demonstrated that EMAP has improved the change detection performance in 36 out of 50 cases. In a third application on land cover classification, we have observed that, with the help of EMAP, using only 4 bands, RGB and NIR, can achieve reasonably accurate land cover classification performance that is only a few percentage points lower than that of using 144 bands of data. Here, we consider an interesting application scenario. At time T1, we have one high-resolution, HR, MS image and a LR MS image. However, at time T2, we only have a LR MS image. It will be important to use the aforementioned images and synthesize a HR MS image at T2. Such scenarios do exist. As shown in, one example is the fusion of Landsat, 30-meter spatial resolution with 16-day revisit period, and MODIS, 500-meter spatial resolution with almost daily revisit. More details can be found in. Another application scenario is the fusion of WorldView with planet images. A third temporal fusion study is for Landsat and WorldView images. Once the fused images are available, more frequent change detection can then be performed for a given area. Fusion of Landsat and MODIS images to create a high spatial and high temporal resolution image sequence. Alban Wan and Shin's lecture on spatiotemporal discusses various spatiotemporal fusion methods for remote sensing images. Pixel, feature, and decision-level fusion approaches were summarized. A few past results from the author's past papers were also included. Spatial domain. Here, we focus on methods that use only a single image to improve the spatial resolution. The simplest method is the bicubic interpolation, which does not utilize any external information such as point spread function, PSF. A total of 16 neighbors are used to generate a prediction, and the performance is better than bilinear interpolation, which uses only 4 neighbors. Recently, there are some new developments. A notable one is the algorithm described in, which utilizes the PSF to improve the resolution of a single image. The super-resolution algorithm in is based on edge interpolation. There is also a group of methods based on deep learning. Vast amounts of training images are needed to train the algorithm. Another group is using dictionary-based approach. Both the deep learning and dictionary approaches require many training images, which may be difficult to obtain. In Sidia and Lee's lecture in this course, a generative adversarial network, GAN-based approach was introduced to face image enhancement. The key distinction from conventional GAN is that it is an unsupervised approach, meaning that no ground truth images are required for training. Experimental results showed that the proposed unsupervised approach is only 1 to 2 dBs inferior to state-of-the-art supervised algorithms. The lecture also pointed out some failure cases, which the authors knew the reasons and will further improve the results in the future. In Chinat Al's lecture, the authors present a new framework for fusing results from cross-view images for 3D mesh reconstruction. Real satellite and ground view images were used to demonstrate the proposed framework. It was found that the reconstruction accuracy has been improved by close to 1 meter in one of the areas. Spatial spectral resolution enhancement, pan sharpening. In many applications, we may have a high resolution, HR, image with only a few bands and another image having low resolution but many bands. Pan sharpening is an image fusion approach that fuses one high spatial resolution image with another low resolution, LR, multispectral, MS, image. Earlier pan sharpening algorithms are limited to images where the panchromatic band overlaps with the MS bands. However, recent advancements have extended the approach to non-overlapping bands. There are two recent survey papers in pan sharpening. In recent studies, pan sharpened images were observed to improve the performance of some applications. Another lecture in this course by Chu et al. Summarizes a Dirichlet net for pan sharpening. The algorithm was applied to Maskam image enhancement. In Ristaino et al.'s lecture, the authors report an interesting study of using multi-platform data for pan sharpening. That is, the low-resolution hyperspectral data and the high-resolution pan or multispectral data come from different satellites. Spectral enhancement using synthetic bands. In some applications, only MS images are available. It may be useful to synthesize some hyperspectral images using those images so that the performance of some applications can be improved. Recently, there have been some new algorithms such as the Extended Morphological Attribute Profiles, EMAP, algorithm for synthesizing spectral bands. Here, rather than explaining the details of EMAP, we would like to mention a few recent applications of EMAP. The first one is to use EMAP for soil detection. The original MS images have 8 bands. After applying EMAP, 80 synthetic bands were generated. The soil detection performance was improved quite significantly. More details can be found in. Another application is on change detection using heterogeneous images. That is, the images at two different times may not come from the same imager. In, we have demonstrated that EMAP has improved the change detection performance in 36 out of 50 cases. In a third application on land cover classification, we have observed that, with the help of EMAP, using only 4 bands, RGB and NIR, can achieve reasonably accurate land cover classification performance that is only a few percentage points lower than that of using 144 bands of data. Spatiotemporal fusion. Here, we consider an interesting application scenario. At time T1, we have one high-resolution, HR, MS image and a LR-MS image. However, at time T2, we only have a LR-MS image. It will be important to use the aforementioned images and synthesize a HR-MS image at T2. Such scenarios do exist. As shown in, one example is the fusion of Landsat, 30-meter spatial resolution with 16-day revisit period, and MODIS, 500-meter spatial resolution with almost daily revisit. More details can be found in. Another application scenario is the fusion of WorldView with planet images. A third temporal fusion study is for Landsat and WorldView images. Once the fused images are available, more frequent change detection can then be performed for a given area. Fusion of Landsat and MODIS images to create a high spatial and high temporal resolution image sequence. Alban Wan and Chen's lecture on spatiotemporal discusses various spatiotemporal fusion methods for remote sensing images. Pixel, feature, and decision-level fusion approaches were summarized. A few past results from the author's past papers were also included. Image denoising. Image noise can be introduced during the image acquisition process. For example, in low lighting conditions, pixel amplitude-dependent noise, Poisson noise, are introduced. In the past, people have investigated sparsity-based methods and deep learning methods. There are also joint denoising and demosaicing algorithms. Image demosaicing. Many commercial cameras have incorporated the Bayer pattern, which is also known as color filter array, CFA, 1.0. An example of CFA 1.0 is shown in A. There are many repetitive 2x2 blocks and, in each block, 2 green, 1 red, and 1 blue pixels are present. To save cost, The mass came onboard the Mars rover Curiosity also adopted the Bayer pattern. Due to the popularity of CFA 1.0, Kodak researchers invented a red, green, blue, white, RGBW, pattern or CFA 2.0. An example of the RGBW pattern is shown in B. In each 4x4 block, 8 white pixels, 4 green pixels, and 2 red and blue pixels are present. Having more white pixels is believed to help improve the sensitivity of the camera, which is important in low lighting conditions. Numerous other CFA patterns have been invented in the past few decades. 3 CFA patterns. A. CFA 1.0. B. CFA 2.0. It will be good to illustrate the differences between a state-of-the-art method, Demonet, and the NASA's current demosaicing algorithm known as Malverhi-Cutler, MHE. From, it can be seen that the demosaiced images by MHE contain some color distortion artifacts whereas the Demonet images do not have noticeable color distortions. Comparative of demosaicing images. Left column, NASA's existing software, right column, state-of-the-art deep learning approach. There are some new developments in demosaicing CFA 2.0 or RGBW. In, a new pan-sharpening approach was proposed to demosaic RGBW patterns. In, a further improved version by combining deep learning and pan-sharpening was proposed. In, a comparative study of the performance of CFA 1.0 and CFA 2.0 for low-lighting images was carried out. It was found that CFA 2.0 has advantages over CFA 1.0 in low lighting conditions. It was also observed that denoising can further enhance the demosaicing performance. Finally, a new CFA 3.0 was proposed in which a comparative study among CFAs 1.0, 2.0, and 3.0 was conducted. It was observed that CFA 2.0 has better performance in terms of peak signal-to-noise ratio, PSNR, in low lighting conditions than CFAs 1.0 and 3.0. CFA 3.0 has better performance than CFA 1.0. Image deblurring. Image blurring can be caused by camera motion and built-in factors such as point spread functions in various stages of image formation. In the course, a few PSFs are mentioned, including optical, motion, detector, and electronics. For motion-induced blurring, researchers have developed estimation methods to restore the original images. For NASA's MASCAM application, an interesting approach was proposed to improve the left MASCAM images. The idea was to use the left and right MASCAM images to estimate the deblurring kernel, and then a deconvolution is applied to deblur the left images. Image in painting. Image in painting is a well-known technique for image restoration. One can remove some image contents and then replace those missing contents with fictitious information. Some conventional techniques include field of experts, FOE, Laplacian method, local matrix completion sparse LMCS, and transformic. More recent methods used GAN for inpainting. We briefly describe these methods below. FOE, the field of experts method, FOE, was developed by Roth et al. This method uses pre-trained models that are used to filter out noise and obstructions in images. Laplacian, this method fills in each missing pixel using the Laplacian interpolation formula by finding the mean of the surrounding known values. Local matrix completion sparse, LMCS, in LMCS, which was developed by us, a search is performed for each missing pixel to find a pixel with the most similar neighbors. After the search, the missing pixel is replaced with the found pixel. This method performs very well with images containing repeating patterns. Transformic, the transformic method was developed by Mansfield et al. It is similar to the LMCS in that it searches the whole image for a patch that is similar to the neighbors of the missing pixel. However, this method transforms and rotates the searched area to find a better match. Generative inpainting, GEN-IN, a new inpainting method, generative inpainting, GEN-IN, which is a deep learning-based method, was considered in our research. It was developed at the University of Illinois that aims to outperform typical deep learning methods that use convolutional neural network, CNN, models. GEN-IN builds on CNN and generative adversarial networks in an effort to encourage cohesion between created and existing pixels. We briefly mention a few recent applications. In, The LMCS technique was applied to automatic target recognition. A recent application of LMCS, transformic, and deep learning can be found in for error concealment in infrared images. In the lecture by Kwan et al., a number of conventional and deep learning methods were applied to digital terrain model, DTM, extraction, compression artifact reduction. It is surprising that JPEG image compression codec is still being used in some applications nowadays. For instance, the Mars rover Curiosity has a number of imagers, which are all using JPEG for image compression. The current practice at NASA is to use low compression ratios, which can only achieve around 3 times of compression efficiency. Since the invention of JPEG in early 1990s, there have been quite a few newer and more powerful compression standards in the literature. In the past few years, there are studies on evaluating a number of compression codecs that can achieve perceptually lossless compression. The findings showed that it is feasible to attain 10-to-1 compression with almost no loss of image quality. Future directions. Although there are some encouraging progress in image restoration in recent years, there are still some tough problems ahead. We list a few directions below. Earlier, we have seen that temporal resolution can be enhanced by fusing two sequences of images, one with high revisit times but low resolution and another just the opposite. After fusion, a sequence of high spatial resolution and high temporal resolution images emerges. The new sequence of images can be used for more frequent change detection, land cover classification, etc. However, based on our investigations, the change detection performance is still limited. The reason is that the enhanced images fail to capture the changes sometimes. More research is needed. Moreover, spectral enhancements sometimes have mixed results. In some applications, we do not see improvement for some reasons. This implies that more research is needed to determine that under what conditions the IMAP-based methods can provide improvement and under what conditions not. For real blurred images collected from cameras, we noticed that some of the open source code still could not get good deblurring results. This is perhaps due to the fact that the camera motion may be nonlinear, jerky motion, and existing kernel estimation methods cannot handle such nonlinear motions. Again, more research is needed in this area. As mentioned earlier, color images using color filter arrays collected in low lighting environments contain Poisson noise that seriously affect the image quality. Image denoising needs to combine with demosaicing in order to yield high-quality images. We believe there is still room for improvement in this area. One possible direction is to investigate deep learning approaches. In many remote sensing applications, we may have high-resolution images at one time but may only have low-resolution images at another time. It will be good to perform change detection across multiple platforms. There are some recent advances in change detection using multimodal or heterogeneous images. For example, Zeman et al. Studied change detection using a mixture of multispectral and synthetic aperture radar, SAR, images. However, more research is still needed to yield consistent results. Image enhancement. Earlier, we have seen that temporal resolution can be enhanced by fusing two sequences of images, one with high revisit times but low resolution and another just the opposite. After fusion, a sequence of high spatial resolution and high temporal resolution images emerges. The new sequence of images can be used for more frequent change detection, land cover classification, etc. However, based on our investigations, the change detection performance is still limited. The reason is that the enhanced images fail to capture the changes sometimes. More research is needed. Moreover, spectral enhancements sometimes have mixed results. In some applications, we do not see improvement for some reasons. This implies that more research is needed to determine that under what conditions the IMAP-based methods can provide improvement and under what conditions not. Image deblurring. For real blurred images collected from cameras, we noticed that some of the open source code still could not get good deblurring results. This is perhaps due to the fact that the camera motion may be nonlinear, jerky motion, and existing kernel estimation methods cannot handle such nonlinear motions. Again, more research is needed in this area. Image demosaicing. As mentioned earlier, color images using color filter arrays collected in low lighting environments contain Poisson noise that seriously affect the image quality. Image denoising needs to combine with demosaicing in order to yield high-quality images. We believe there is still room for improvement in this area. One possible direction is to investigate deep learning approaches. Change detection using heterogeneous images. In many remote sensing applications, we may have high-resolution images at one time but may only have low-resolution images at another time. It will be good to perform change detection across multiple platforms. There are some recent advances in change detection using multimodal or heterogeneous images. For example, Zeman et al. Study change detection using a mixture of multispectral and synthetic aperture radar, SAR, images. However, more research is still needed to yield consistent results. Introduction. The Curiosity rover has several instruments that are used to characterize the Mars surface. For example, the Alpha Particle X-ray Spectrometer, APXS, can analyze rock samples collected from the robotic arm and extract compositions of rocks. The Laser-Induced Breakdown Spectroscopy, LIBS, can extract spectral features from the vaporized fumes and deduce the rock compositions at a distance of 7 meters, and the mass chem imagers can perform surface characterization from 1 kilometer away. Curiosity rover and its onboard instruments. The two mass chem multispectral imagers are separated by 24.2 centimeters. As shown in the left mass chem, 34 millimeters focal length, has 3 times the field of view of the right mass cam, 100 mm focal length. In other words, the right imager has 3 times higher resolution than that of the left. To generate stereo image or construct a 12-band image cube by fusing bands from the multispectral imagers from the left and right mass cams, a practical solution is to downsample the resolution of the right images to that of the left images, which would avoid the artifacts caused by Bayer pattern or the JPEG compression loss. Although this approach has practical merits, it may restrict the potential ability of mass cams. First, downsampling the right images will throw away those high spatial resolution pixels in the right bands. Second, the lower resolution of the current stereo images may degrade the augmented reality or virtual reality experience of users. If one can apply some advanced pan sharpening algorithms to the left bands, then one can have 12 bands of high-resolution image cube for the purpose of stereo vision and image fusion. The two mass cam imagers. A. Left mass cam. B. Right mass cam. In the past 2 decades, there have been many papers discussing the fusion of a high-resolution panchromatic, PAN, image with a low-resolution multispectral image, MSI. This is known as pan sharpening. In our recent papers, we proposed an unsupervised network structure to address the image fusion / super resolution, SR, problem for hyperspectral image, HSI, referred to as HSI-SR, where a low resolution, LR, HSI with high spectral resolution and a high resolution, HR, MSI with low spectral resolution are fused to generate an HSI with high resolution in both spatial and spectral dimensions. Similar to MSI, HSI has found extensive applications. In this lecture, we adopt the innovative approaches designed in, referred to as unsupervised sparse Dirichlet network, used in, to enhance mass cam images, where we treat the right mass cam image as MSI with higher spatial resolution and the left mass cam image as HSI with low spatial resolution. In this lecture, we focus on the application of used in to enhance mass cam images. In section 2, we first introduce the problem of HSI-SR and then briefly summarize the key ideas of USDIN. In section 3, we apply USDIN on actual mass cam images. In section 4, we include some further enhancements of USDIN in experiments. In section 5, we introduce a transition learning concept, which is a natural extension of USDIN. Some preliminary results are also included. Finally, we conclude the lecture with some remarks. The USDIN algorithm for HSI-SR. In this section, we describe the USDIN algorithm developed in. For more details, please refer to the reference. First of all, we will formulate the problem of HSI-SR to facilitate the discussion of mass cam enhancement. Table 1 summarizes the mathematical symbols used in this lecture. Symbols and abbreviations. The basic idea of USDIN is illustrated in. First, the LRHSI. Macron RM times N times L with its width, height, and number of spectral bands denoted as M, N, and L, respectively, is unfolded into a 2D matrix, YRM N times L. Similarly, the HRMSI, Y Macron RM times N times L with its width, height, and number of spectral bands denoted as M, N, and L, respectively, is unfolded into a 2D matrix Y-MARM-N times L. And the SRHSI, X macron RM times N times L, is unfolded into a 2D matrix X RM-N times L. Note that, generally, the spatial resolution of the MSI is much higher than that of the HSI, that is, MM, NN, and the spectral resolution of HSI is much higher than that of the MSI, that is, LL. The objective is to reconstruct the high spatial and spectral resolution HSI, X macron RM times N times L, with LRHSI and HRMSI. General procedure of HSI-SR. Due to the limitation of hardware, each pixel in an HSI or MSI may cover more than one constituent materials, leading to mixed pixels. These mixtures can be assumed to be a linear combination of a few basis vectors, or source signatures. Both LRHSI and HRMSI-WIME can be assumed to be a linear combination of C basis vectors with their corresponding proportional coefficients, referred to as representations in deep learning, as expressed in EECS. 1, and, 2, where phi HRC times L and phi MRC times L denote the spectral basis of E and WIME, respectively. They preserve the spectral information of the images. SHRMN times C and SMRMN times C are the proportional coefficients of E and WIME, respectively. Since the coefficients indicate how much each spectral basis has in constructing the mixed pixel at specific spatial locations, they preserve the spatial structure of HSI. The relationship between HSI and MSI bases can be expressed in the right part of 2, where our RL times L is the transformation matrix given as a prior from the sensor. With phi HRC times L carrying the high spectral information and SMRMN times C carrying the high spatial information, the desired HRHSI, X, is generated by 3. C? Since the ground truth X is not available, the problem has to be solved in an unsupervised fashion. In addition, the linear combination assumption enforces the representation vectors of HSI or MSI to be non-negative and sum to 1, that is, J equals 1 Ch equals 1, where C is the row vector of either SM or SH. The used unsupervised architecture is shown in. It has three unique structures. First, the network consists of two encoder-decoder networks, to extract the representations of the LRHSI and HRMSI, respectively. The two networks share the same decoder, such that both the spectral and spatial information from multimodalities can be extracted with unsupervised settings. Second, the representations of both modalities, SH and SM, are enforced to follow a Dirichlet distribution with a sum to 1 and non-negative properties are naturally incorporated into the network. The solution space is further regularized with a sparsity constraint. Third, the angular difference of the representations from two modalities is minimized to preserve the spectral information of the reconstructed HRHSI. Simplified architecture of USEN. Mastcam image enhancement using USEN with improvements. USEN has been thoroughly evaluated with two widely used benchmark datasets, CAVE and Harvard. Details can be found in. Here, we adopt USEN to enhance the resolution of Mastcam images. As mentioned earlier, the right Mastcam has high resolution than the left. Hence, we treat the right Mastcam images as HRMSI and the left images as LRHSI. Although USEN was introduced to deal with the general HSI super resolution problem, we can treat the Mastcam image enhancement simply as a special case of HSI-SR. For quantitative comparison, the root mean squared error, RMSE, and spectral angle mapper, SAM, are applied to evaluate the reconstruction error and the amount of spectral distortion, respectively. The results are shown in. The reconstructed image is very close to the ground truth. Most methods require that the size of high-resolution image should be equal to an integer multiplication of the size of low-resolution image. Thus, we only compare the method with CNNF which works for arbitrary image size. The results are shown in Table 2. We observe that USEN is able to outperform the CNNF. Results of Mastcam image enhancement using USEN. The left column shows the six bands from the left camera. The middle column shows the corresponding reconstructed results. The right column shows the six bands from the right camera. Evaluations for image enhancement from Mastcam. In this section, We summarize some further improvements of UFS by fine-tuning the existing network structure in use in order to further enhance the fusion performance. The existing structure of UFS described in Section 3.1 is improved in two ways. First, in Section 3.1, the architecture consists of two deep networks, for the representation learning of the LRHSI and HRMSI, respectively. And only the decoders of the LRHSI and HRHSI networks are shared. The spectral information, i.e., the decoder of the LRHSI network, is extracted through the LRHSI network. Then the representation layer of the HRHSI is optimized by enforcing the spectral angle similarity. However, this introduces additional cost function, that is, angular difference minimization, and the optimization procedure is time-consuming. In the improved UDSON, for the HRHSI network, most of the encoder weights are shared with the weights of the LRHSI encoder. Only a couple of encoder weights are updated during the HRHSI optimization. In this way, both the representations of the LRHSI and HRHSI networks are reinforced to follow Dirichlet distributions with parameters following the same trends. And the representations extracted from the LRHSI matches the patterns of that extracted from the HRHSI as shown in representations extracted from the LRHSI, top row, and the HRHSI, bottom row. Second, to further reduce the spectral distortion of the estimated HRHSI, instead of using L2 loss, we adopt the L21 loss, which encourages the network to reduce the spectral loss of each pixel. Compared to the network with L2 loss, the network with L21 loss is able to extract spectral information images more accurately. The L21 loss can not only reduce the spectral distortion of the estimated HRHSI, but also improve the convergence speed of the network. The result of the proposed method on individual HSI is visualized in. When we optimize the network with L21 loss, we can observe that the difference between the estimated MSI and the ground truth MSI is very small, with RMSE of 1.7428 and SAM of 0.25615. The results using improved USDN. The left column shows the first two bands from the left camera. The second column shows the corresponding reconstructed images from the improved USDN. The third column shows the reference images from the right camera. The right column shows the absolute difference between the reconstructed images and the reference images. Applying USDN for mass cam enhancement. USDN has been thoroughly evaluated with two widely used benchmark datasets, CAVE and Harvard. Details can be found in. Here, we adopt UDSN to enhance the resolution of mass cam images. As mentioned earlier, the right mass cam has high resolution than the left. Hence, we treat the right mastcam images are HRMSI and the left images as LRHSI. Although USDN was introduced to deal with the general HSI super resolution problem, we can treat the mastcam image enhancement simply as a special case of HSI-SR. For quantitative comparison, the root mean squared error, RMSE, and spectral angle mapper, SAM, are applied to evaluate the reconstruction error and the amount of spectral distortion, respectively. The results are shown in. The reconstructed image is very close to the ground truth. Most methods require that the size of high-resolution image should be equal to an integer multiplication of the size of low-resolution image. Thus, we only compare the method with CNNF which works for arbitrary image size. The results are shown in Table 2. We observe that USDN is able to outperform the CNNF. Results of mastcam image enhancement using USDN. The left column shows the six bands from the left camera. The middle column shows the corresponding reconstructed results. The right column shows the six bands from the right camera. Evaluations for image enhancement from mastcam. Improvement based on USDN. In this section, we summarize some further improvements of UDSN by fine-tuning the existing network structure in USDN in order to further enhance the fusion performance. The existing structure of UDSN described in Section 3.1 is improved in two ways. First, in Section 3.1, the architecture consists of two deep networks, for the representation learning of the LRHSI and HRMSI, respectively. And only the decoders of the LRHSI and HRHSI networks are shared. The spectral information, i.e., the decoder of the LRHSI network, is extracted through the LRHSI network. then the representation layer of the HRHSI is optimized by enforcing the spectral angle similarity. However, this introduces additional cost function, that is, angular difference minimization, and the optimization procedure is time-consuming. In the improved UDSON, for the HRHSI network, most of the encoder weights are shared with the weights of the LRHSI encoder. Only a couple of encoder weights are updated during the HRHSI optimization. In this way, both the representations of the LRHSI and HRHSI networks are reinforced to follow Dirichlet distributions with parameters following the same trends. And the representations extracted from the LRHSI matches the patterns of that extracted from the HRHSI as shown in representations extracted from the LRHSI, top row, and the HRHSI, bottom row. Second, to further reduce the spectral distortion of the estimated HRHSI, instead of using L2 loss, we adopt the L21 loss, which encourages the network to reduce the spectral loss of each pixel. Compared to the network with L2 loss, the network with L21 loss is able to extract spectral information images more accurately. The L21 loss can not only reduce the spectral distortion of the estimated HRHSI, but also improve the convergence speed of the network. The result of the proposed method on individual HSI is visualized in. When we optimize the network with L21 loss, we can observe that the difference between the estimated MSI and the ground truth MSI is very small, with RMSE of 1.7428 and SAM of 0.25615. The results using improved USDEN. The left column shows the first two bands from the left camera. The second column shows the corresponding reconstructed images from the improved USDEN. The third column shows the reference images from the right camera. The right column shows the absolute difference between the reconstructed images and the reference images. Combination of DirichletNet and UNet. In this section, we propose to combine DirichletNet with UNet to mitigate the MIS registration issue in the left and right MASCAM images. Since in real scenarios, the images from the left and right cameras may not match each other perfectly even after registration, we propose a combination of DirichletNet and UNet to further improve the fusion performance using non-perfectly registered patches. We propose an unsupervised architecture as shown in, which consists of two deep networks, an improved DirichletNet for the representation learning of the MSI, and a UNet for switching the low-resolution spatial information patches with high-resolution spatial information patches. Then the HRMSI of the left MASCAM image is generated by combining its spectral information with the spatial information of improved resolution. The architecture of the proposed approach that combines DirichletNet with UNet. From the last step in, we are able to extract both the spectral and spatial information from LRMSI, left MASCAM, and HRMSI, right MASCAM. Although the scenes from the left and right camera are not the same, we assume they share the same group of spectral bases. And if we could improve the spatial information of the LRMSI using HRMSI, the quality of the LRMSI can be enhanced. The architecture of the UNet is illustrated in the lower part of. We first learn a UNet to recover the extracted spatial information, SM, of HRMSI, WIM, by convolution and deconvolution layers. The convolution layers extract HR spatial features from SM, and the deconvolutional layers take these extracted features to rebuild the spatial information of SMAL. Then we extract features from the spatial patches SH of the LRHSI with the same convolution layers and switch these feature patches with their most similar feature patches in the HR spatial features. Finally, the left MASCAM image with enhanced resolution, X, is generated by feeding the switching patches into deconvolutional layers of UNet and the decoder of the DirichletNet. Here, we show experimental results from the proposed combination, DirichletNet and UNet, approach in figures 9 and 10. We can observe that the reconstructed left MASCAM image is sharper than the raw MSI captured from the left camera directly, and the spectral distortion of the recovered MSI is small, although only part of the high-resolution MSI, right MASCAM image, is given from the right camera. Note that, due to the memory constraint, only a small patch can be recovered every time, thus there exists some disconnected parts in the results. This issue will be addressed in section 5. The results of test image MSL_0002_0114_M1. The top row shows the six bands of raw images from the left camera. The bottom row shows the corresponding reconstructed images from the proposed method. The cropped results of test image MSL_0002_0114_M1. The top row shows the 6 bands of raw images from the left camera. The bottom row shows the corresponding reconstructed images from the proposed method. Spatial representation improvement with transition learning. High spatial resolution images have one natural property, that is, the transitions among pixel values are smooth. The patch-based method aims to replace the LR patches from the LR-MSI representations SH with the most similar HR patches from the HR-MSI representation, small since the LR-MSI and HR-MSI are unregistered and there is no ground truth of enhanced MSI, the patch-based improvement could not guarantee the smooth transitions in the reconstructed images, that is, the replaced patches may not match their neighbors. Therefore, in this section, we propose another structure based on transition learning, to further improve the spatial resolution of LRHSI. The main structure is shown in the architecture of the proposed transition learning approach. To learn smooth transitions between pixels, we first extract sub-images from the representations SM of HR-MSI with stride 3, as shown in the lower part of. For example, since the super resolution factor is 3, we extract 9 sub-images from small, then the network learns the transitions between the center sub-image with the other 8 sub-images. Since the LR-MSI and HR-MSI have similar statistic distributions, we assume that the transitions among pixels in both modalities are the same. Therefore, the representations SH of LR-MSI can be treated as the center sub-image of enhanced MSI and the other 8 sub-images of enhanced MSI can be estimated by feeding the representations SH of LR-MSI into the network trained by small. There are still residuals between the reconstructed and the ideal representations of small this time. We adopt the principle described earlier to add high-frequency residuals on the enhanced MSI. Here, the experimental results of the proposed approaches are compared with the results from bicubic and the state-of-the-art single-image super-resolution method EnhancedNet, as shown in figures 12-14. Note that, since the EnhancedNet only offers the 4x pre-trained weights, we show its 4x reconstruction results for fair comparison, in case the downsampling procedure reduces the quality of the reconstructed images. The bicubic does not improve the resolution much. The EnhancedNet was trained on natural image dataset, thus it works poorly on remote sensing images. Compared to the bicubic or EnhancedNet methods, we can observe that the proposed methods can not only improve the spatial resolution of LR-MSI, but also preserve the spectral information well, even though the images from the left and right camera are not registered. The transition-based approach works better than the patch-based one, because it learns the relationship between the reconstructed pixels. The results of the test image MSL_0002_0114_M1. The left column shows the 6 bands of raw images from the left camera. The second, third, fourth and fifth columns show the corresponding reconstructed images from bicubic, EnhancedNet, the proposed patch-based method and the residual-based transition learning method, respectively. The cropped results of the test image MSL_0002_0114_M1. The left column shows the 6 bands of raw images from the left camera. The second, third, fourth, and fifth columns show the corresponding reconstructed images from bicubic, EnhancedNet, the proposed patch-based method and the residual-based transition learning method, respectively. The cropped results of the test image MSL_0002_0114_M1. The left column shows the 6 bands of raw images from the left camera. The second, third, fourth, and fifth columns show the corresponding reconstructed images from bicubic, EnhancedNet, the proposed patch-based method and the residual-based transition learning method, respectively.